Hello and welcome to Fade's WoW Gold Rush, a video series dedicated to showing you quick ways to make gold with limited time in World of Warcraft, in which all the tips and tricks are ways to make gold with 15 minutes or less of playtime. I hope you enjoy. Here we go.
I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You know it's me when I come through your town.
Hi guys, today we're going to be doing inscription. I'm going to focus on non-glyph inscription because, quite honestly, you shouldn't need a video to tell you that glyphs make money. So we're going to do non-glyphs. Not to mention, glyphs can take some time, and this is all about fast gold making, so let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and start out by buying a couple stacks of Whiptail. I'm going to end up spending just under 29 gold a stack for it. I end up with 8 stacks, and it costs me about 232 gold. What I'm doing here is I'm banking on the fact that when I mill this, I will be able to get the materials to either flat out sell at a profit, or to make things which sell at a profit. So we're gonna go ahead and mill it and find out if that happens. When milling, I highly recommend you stick only to Cataclysm herbs. Most of the items that are made with lower level herbs won't be in demand, other than of course the glyphs. What we really wanna do is make sure we have options like Mysterious Fortune cards, Dust of Disappearance, etc. So we wanna stick to Cataclysm herbs. When doing Cataclysm herbs, Whiptail and Twilight Jasmine will give you the best amounts of pigment for the herbs. However, Twilight Jasmine seems to be pretty expensive, so I tend to stick to Whiptail. And Cinderbloom, Mishara's Veil, and Stormvine can all be great choices if they're cheap on your server. I end up with enough pigment to make 48 Blackfallow ink, and it looks like 9 Inferno ink. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sell the Inferno ink on the auction house, because though you can make cards, I really don't want to invest that much Volatile Life personally. It's always an option though for those who like to, or use it for other things such as Royal Scribe Satchels. I'd rather just get rid of it, sell it right away. After a quick auction house check, I've found that Dust of Disappearance is going for about 10.5 gold per piece, and the Mysterious Fortune cards are going for 11 gold a piece, both of which means that they're pretty good markets and I'll definitely profit. So I'm going to make a good mix of both of those. The great thing about Dust of Disappearance is most players think it's entirely reasonable to pay 8 to 10 gold a piece for these, which is great because that's what the vendor charges. However, as a scribe, one Black Fallow ink will make 3 Dust of Disappearance, aka 30 gold of value in most players' eyes. So if I can sell those, then that's great. Sure, you could sell them at the vendor price. You could even try and sell them over the vendor price and try and take advantage of people. I'd rather say, hey, you're getting a deal, and I sell them for 5 to 7 gold per piece. They are getting a discount off what they'd usually pay, and I'm still getting a really good profit off of what I want to sell for. So that's why I tend to sell Dust of Disappearance at this rate. But hey, that's 21 gold for every Blackfallow ink, and that's a pretty damn good deal. Considering this ratio, Mysterious Fortune cards are usually less of a profit. However, you can often get a person who's going to buy them to buy a lot more than you'd get someone to buy a whole bunch of Dust of Disappearance. So I like to have a good mix of both to keep sales going, and because I've just got a lot of ink laying around. Both of these markets really, really benefit from barking, so you're going to want to make macros of, hey, Mysterious Fortune Guard's up, or my personal favorite macro for Dust of Disappearance, stock up now, you know you'll need it eventually. Get Dust of Disappearance on the auction house now for less than the vendor price. And then people tend to jump on that as quickly as they can, because it's true, they're going to need it eventually. At the end of all of that, just through selling Dust of Disappearance, Inferno Ink, and Mysterious Fortune Cards, I took an investment of about 240 gold after parchment, and I ended up posting auctions worth about 1,030 gold. So just like that, I quadrupled my money with inscription without even having to touch glyphs. So I hope that helps you guys out. Have a lot of fun, make a lot of gold.